The platypus is a duck-billed aquatic mammal that lays eggs. The platypod is a spike-footed camera support that fits in your pocket. We're going to be talking about one of these on today's show. Good morning and welcome to PhotoJoseph's Photo Moment, the first live three times a week show here at youtube.com/PhotoJoseph every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 9:30 a.m. Pacific time, talking about photography, video, live streaming, and all kinds of fun things related. This is a live show. If you're watching it and you're not live, you should be live because then you get to participate in the chat like this. You come up in the chat room, you say my name, I see your question, and we address them. We typically do that at the end of the show. We'll do a second round of this where we go through and answer all your questions. And they don't have to be just about today's topic. They can be about whatever you want, but obviously today's topic is the topic we most want to discuss. So today's topic is this thing called the Platypod. This one specifically is the Platypod Ultra. And a special thanks out to the folks at Platypod who gave this to me and gave one of these to all of the speakers at the Out of Chicago conference that many of you missed, but not all of you, because some of you were there earlier this year. Fantastic conference, by the way. If you ever get a chance to attend, please do. And this is in our speaker gift goodie bag, which is fantastic. And it's one of those things I've seen many, many times before and thought, I should get one of those. And I just never did. So now I've got one and I'm very happy to have it in my hands. Platypod, by the way, is here in the live chat today. So if you have any questions about the product that I don't know the answer to or that you just don't want to wait for me to get to, by all means, post them in the comments, tag Platypod in them, and they will address the question for you right away. So with that said, what is this thing? This thing is essentially a camera support. I don't want to call it a tripod. It could be a tripod if you put three spikes in it, but it is a camera support that is very, very versatile. Let's take a close-up look at the product itself. Let's go in for a little close-up view here. It is a hunk of chunk of metal with a bunch of funny holes in it. We'll go through kind of what all these are, and a 3/8-16 post on the bottom there. That allows you to screw in something like a ball head that would attach onto there, at which point you could then put your camera on top of all of that. This thing here also comes with a bag full of spiky feet, very, very sharp spiky feet. Don't drop that on your foot. And a carabiner to hold it all together and a Velcro strap, all of which are at its most base level, this thing to other things. So here's effectively how it works. At its most base level, don't just forget about all this for a moment. You can take this with a ball head, put this on here. That was loud in the microphone. I realize I'm very sorry. Metal on metal is a bad combination. Put this on here, attach your camera to this. Let's go ahead and do that actually. Why not? I'm gonna put my camera onto here. And then what we've got is a lovely little platform to put my camera on. So I can position this wherever I want, right? And now obviously at some point, if you go, like if I go crazy leaning far this way, it's gonna fall over, right? I mean, you gotta balance it. But the idea here is that I can now put my camera anywhere at a low position on the floor, trunk of the car shooting out, you know, great for photo and video. And you can put it wherever you like. And it's not just about your camera. You can put a light on here. You could put a monitor. I actually attached a Atomos Ninja monitor to this and had it on the floor for a shoot I was doing last week. And I was like, I need to tilt this. How am I going to tilt this thing up? And I thought, oh, the Platypod. Perfect. Put this on the floor and away you go. So notice that at this point, we haven't attached any of the accessories. This is an important thing. You don't actually need to use the accessories. If the surface you're resting it on is relatively flat, then away you go. You got your ball head and off you go on it. Now, I am going to point out one thing that I think I would like to see as a design change. And this is something that I think would be quite useful. And maybe they've already considered this and there's a reason they haven't done it. But the post on the bottom of this is a 3/8-16 post. So that's what we're looking at here. This is a big old 3/8-16 on it, which means I cannot put my camera directly on it. While I realize that the use of this would be somewhat limited, there's not that many situations where you could just put that on there and that would be useful, I think there might be some, especially when we start screwing in one or two of the spikes. And I would like to see the ability to mount this directly to the camera. Being that it's a 3/8-16 and not a 1/4-20, you can't. Now you could, the manufacturer could, create this with a 1/4-20 post and then have a 3/8-16 adapter on it. That would be totally viable. It couldn't be a retractable one like this. This is my Manfrotto ball head. This has this cool retractable post. You couldn't do that because there's nowhere for it to retract down to, but there are collars, basically a hollow screw bit, if you will, that you can screw over the 1/4-20 to make it a 3/8-16. That's a design change that I would love to see because I think that would make it more useful without having to have the ball head. As it is right now, you have to have some type of a head, preferably a ball head, to attach onto here. And obviously, if you have a ball head, that's going to make it the most versatile, right? Then you can tilt it anywhere you want. But if putting it straight forward worked for you, then, well, maybe you could get away without it. In fact, what I did do is I grabbed out of my studio kit and caboodle bag a adapter. This is a 5/8-16 to 1/4-inch adapter. Obviously, it's got some distance on it because, you know, you can't shrink down in size from big to small without defying the laws of physics, but that means I can put that on there and then attach this to the camera, and this works relatively well. Now it does, let's see here, so there, you can see now it's kind of flat on there, and if I do a close-up of that, you can see it's just kind of sitting and hovering on there. So limited usefulness at this stage, I admit, but I would like to have that option. Other than that, I think the product's just about dang perfect. So let's go through what all these different holes are on here, because there are some interesting little holes on here that are very, very useful. So you've got, let's kind of run around them. You have five, one, two, three, four, and five holes for specifically mounting in the spiked feet. And we'll take a look at that in a moment. You do not have to use all four. Well, you can't use all five because there's four screws, but you don't have to use all four of them. You can use three or two or one of them. And that's one of the big things we'll look at. There are countersunk screw holes in here, which is really cool. So you could screw this onto a wall, onto a wooden platform, whatever. You could just screw that in. You could nail it in, obviously, if you got big enough nail heads. And then there are these straps here, these holes, kind of ridges here, that are designed for this strap. So you could just take this strap, put that on like so, and then this is the big Velcro strap that it comes with. Now you can attach this to a tree or telephone pole or whatever. So you could mount it, yeah, you'd want to do it like this, have gravity be in your favor. You could mount it like this, have your ball head here, your camera sticking out, and so on. So there's an option as well. It's a lot of different ways to connect it. That's kind of the fun thing about it. It's like a cheese plate for cinema, if you know what that is. You have the ability to mount all kinds of things to it. It has a variety of screw holes on here that are either quarter 20 or 3/8/16. So you have standard camera photographic mount size screw holes on here ready to go. Pretty slick. And then there's holes here for like the carabiner. Like I said, it comes with a carabiner, so you could just kind of put all the little stuff together if you wanted to do something like this and hang this on the outside of your bag, or just to keep everything together. And it comes with this little carabiner as well. Let's take a quick look. We're gonna mount the screws up in here as well, but let's take a real quick look over at the B&H page. On B&H, I just did a quick search for Platypod. There's a variety of sizes, well, two sizes. There's the Platypod Max, which is the big version, and this comes with a ball head, and that's 168. The one that I've got in my hands right now is the Platypod Ultra with the accessory kit, and this one is $79. So super affordable. I think at $79, this is a really good price. It's an easy thing to have in your bag. And then you can get different kits with other accessories on them as well. But there's two different sizes, the Ultra Plate, which is what I'm holding, and the Max, which is for bigger things. What's interesting is the sizes it says it'll support, the weight. Let's see, where did I see the weight on this one? I don't see the weight listed on here, but it was something like 200 pounds. You got this big one here, versatile design, holds up to 300 pounds. If you got a 300 pound camera, look, dude, we got to talk. But that's awesome. So the thing is seriously built to handle some weight, was what it comes down to. So, you know, kudos to that. So two different sizes of the product. This is the smaller one, the Ultra, ready for, I mean, you could put any size camera. Let's face it, you could put a full-size DSLR in here. Maybe you wouldn't want to do a medium format camera, but I think you could definitely do a normal big camera in here. And obviously for mirrorless, it's fantastic. So let's take a look at the spike thing, because this is one of the really cool things that it does. Let's go for it. Let me pull out the spikes. And we're just going to take one of this to get a close-up of this thing. You can see the spikes the way these are. They have a little rubber cap on the end of it for gripping onto, and then a collar to tighten down if you really want to lock it into position. And the idea here is quite simple. You just take this and screw it into one of the five, or many of the five holes on there. So you can get this thing on here, you can get it on pretty quick. I don't recommend doing this when it's full of spikes and let it go and it flying, that'd probably be bad. But here at this point, we now have a spike, right? It is now tilted up and ready to go. At this point, it's almost like a tripod. Look, 1 point, 2 points, 3 points hitting the ground. This is often all you need. I mean, often, sometimes you just need the platform itself. You put this on and now you can tilt it at an angle. We get a second one and we put it in here, and let's screw this one into this point here. And we'll just go a little bit into here. And now we're putting it at some other kind of funky, jaunty angle. And the idea being that you can get this to a point of stabilizing it to wherever you like. And this comes back to the reason why I think you may not always need to have a ball head on there. At this point, obviously I would not be able to put the camera like this, but I could put the camera at an angle on there if I could tighten it in, and then I could have the spike feet angle it however I need and try and get it stable or try and get it level. It's not just about getting it level though. Having these spikes that you adjust is not just about leveling this out, because if you have a ball head on, then level doesn't matter, right? You adjust it however you like. The folks at Platypod actually sent me a couple of pictures, here we go, just showing different ways that it can be used. So this is what I just showed you, but this is really cool, using it to hang it off of a off of an object. So you kind of hang it off of a rock here. You got the two big spikes over here that are being used as a hanging support, and then let gravity do the rest of the work and hold it into place. So a lot of different ways to mount it and put it together into a clever little way to hold your camera. I think it's really pretty cool. So I've had this for a little while. I've just started using it. I really just started using it here in the studio. Like I said, I have the Atomos monitor on it when I wanted to put that on the floor. At one point I used it to strap a camera to my rigging on here. I just used the strap, strapped it to the rigging. That works out great. I'm looking forward to finding a lot more other uses for it. This does live in my bag now, so this is one of those things that you always have with you. And since it does collapse up so small, you know, you take out the spiked feet and this whole thing goes down really, really little, then there's no excuse not to have it with you, right? I mean, like this, and away you go. And you're set, and that's all there is to it. So pretty neat little setup. I am digging it. So out there in the chat room, tell me and the live audience, tell me, do you have one of these? What clever, interesting uses have you come up with for it? I'd love to hear about it, because there are the obvious, what it's designed for uses, but the way it's designed, it really is created so that you can do just about anything you want with it. And I'd love to hear what you guys might be doing with it. You know where I'm gonna take this thing? You know where this thing's gonna come in really handy? Ooh, let me tell you, this thing's gonna come really handy in India. This is going to be awesome when I go to India. So if you haven't seen this yet, and I'm sure you have if you watch the show, we are going to India next year, the early part of the year. We're going to a few different cities in India to see a bunch of amazing and incredible things and people and places, and you can learn all about it at photojoseph.com/India. Do check that out if you have any interest in attending a workshop/photography tour with me and a few fellow photo enthusiasts, then check it out, photojoseph.com/India. It's going to be a ton of fun. Hopefully I'll see some of you out there. That would be awesome. All right, guys, we're gonna do the Q&A next. Again, we do have Platypod in the live audience today, so if you've got tough questions that I can't answer, they will do their best to answer them for you, and I will be here as well. So with that, let's switch over to the Q&A.